Hey everyone, thanks for watching. I have a show that I have been looking forward to for quite some time now. And we've invited a guest who is actually running for Congress. And I have so many questions, but let's welcome Esmeralda Soria to the show. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me on your show.
Oh, absolutely. You are first off running for Congress. And why would anybody do that? I mean, that running for Congress, being a part of the Washington, D.C. thing, why would a good person like yourself want to do that?
Well, you know, I think that's the million-dollar question, Michael. Thank you for asking. And for me, what I've seen, at least now, given my tenure on the council, is that Congress is broken. It's not working for the regular working people. You know, I've had an opportunity to represent the city of Fresno, the fifth largest city, and I've seen upfront, close up, what are the issues that are impacting the regular working people. I will say that in my opinion, and what I've seen in Washington, D.C., is the big corporate interest. Mm-hmm. It's really mute the voice of just the regular working folk that I run into every single day and that I've been talking to over the course of the last 5 months in my campaign up and down the valley. What I see in our community and what has happened in the last few decades, an increase in poverty, an increase in us being at the bottom when it comes to air quality issues, when it comes to continuing to have communities in our backyard that don't have access to safe drinking water, families that are struggling to have access to healthcare, and students that are struggling to pay for their college education. I am a first generation, born here. My parents came here in the 1970s. You know, I have the typical immigrant story. We've worked hard, we've played by the rules, but my generation is beginning to be that generation that is strapped with college debt. I actually graduated about less than 10 years ago from law school. I decided to invest in myself, but I found myself graduating with a six-figure college debt. And what I tell people, I jokingly say this, but I say, hey, I'm a walking mortgage. I owe, and I'm not embarrassed to say it, but I do owe $150,000 in college debt. That is the reality of a lot of folks, in particular, folks in the middle class that are trying to get that college education, that are trying to get educated to get that better paying job. But as a result, there's tons of families. And I don't know if you've seen the statistics in our country, $1.3 trillion in college debt. And that, I believe, actually hinders our economy. Because imagine if I had those extra dollars rather than paying, you know, the $1,500 every month into, you know, this loan that has significant interest, I could actually be putting it back to the local economy and those dollars, you know, recycle back. And I know it because I work for the residents of the city of Fresno. And every year we struggle with the revenues that come in to cover police, fire, infrastructure, our parks, making sure that we're also building more affordable housing in our community. So these challenges are tied. And what I have found is that we need representatives in Congress that are actually representing just the regular working folks that understand their issues intimately. And I'm one of them. And right. That's what I feel. I feel that I will provide a stronger voice for the ordinary people that live in the valley that are struggling on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah. And again, I think, so first off, thank you, right? We, the American people, need people with your background, your roots, who are just the regular people, willing to take on the, you know, the big corporate entities and change Washington. It's going to take lots of people like you stepping up. So first off, thank you. I would never do that, but as long as you're brave enough to go for it, I'm willing to support you.
So thank you.
That's pretty awesome. So let's give people a little bit more color on who you are as an individual, right? Again, first generation. You went to law school. I mean, there's so much more about you. Why don't you give just a little more color on who you are as a person, and then we'll go from there.
Thank you. So I grew up in a neighboring county in Tulare County, small city of the city of Lindsay. My parents, as I mentioned, in the 1970s came to this country as immigrants with a dream that they would provide their five children or their children to be, because they had us all here, the opportunity to have the American dream. Right. And my parents were farm workers for a majority of their life. But what they always told us is make sure you work hard, make sure that you don't forget where you come from, and that you give back to your community, and that you make sure that when you leave this earth, you've done something to improve the lives of other people, especially the folks coming behind us. One of the things that my mother always reminded me growing up is, to whom much is given, much is required. And I feel that I have been extremely blessed in my professional journey. We grew up poor, but that didn't set me back. I think it only motivated me to want to improve my life so that at some point I could help my parents out, you know, and that's what we've done. We all my four other siblings, we all went to college. Three of us went to Berkeley. I went to UC Davis for law school. I have a sister that is got her doctorate from Fresno State. She went to USC for her master's. My brother also went to get his master's. So we are, you know, truly the example of how education can transform your family in one generation. My father has a seventh grade education. My mom had a ninth grade education. And so they understood the value of making sure that we got an education so that we could do something better. And that's what we did. But we also recognized that it was important for us to come back to our community to make a difference. And, you know, what I will say is that all my siblings and I, we all went away to college, but we all have made our return back to the Central Valley. And in fact, all my siblings live in Lindsay. I'm the only one that lives here in the city of Fresno. I kind of moved back to what to me was the big city and would provide more job opportunities. Another thing about my siblings, three of my sisters are also elected officials. One serves on the school board. She was the first one. I actually ran her campaign about 7 years ago. She's on the school board. She's been there for a number of years. My oldest sister is on the city council there. And then my youngest sister is on the local hospital district. Again, we are like totally the example of serving our community, wanting to do something to improve the lives of other people. Wow. And, you know, 6 years ago, when I decided to run for office here in the city of Fresno, I also noticed that there was a gap and there was a void in the voice for regular working people and someone that was willing to roll up their sleeves and do the hard work on a number of issues. You know, I've been able to work across the aisle to work with folks to make sure that we get grocery stores, to make sure that we're building parks, to make sure that we're bringing community centers. One of the projects that I'm really proud of, and we'll start seeing it start get built early in, you know, probably January, February, it's going to be on McKinley and Blackstone. Mm-hmm. It is an 88 housing mixed-use development that is going to have a seven-day-a-week walk-in clinic for, you know, every person that needs health care and dental care. And we'll have our first neighborhood senior center space right across the street from City College. And I'm sure you've driven by that area, Michael, and you know, it's not too far from where your new office is at the hub, but it's going to transform that area.
Yeah.
It is a $38 million investment. So those are the types of projects that I'm proud of to have worked in the city of Fresno. Those are kind of the bigger ones, but I'm as proud as, you know, the art on the crosswalk. Those were kind of, we pioneered, you know, adding art and beautifying the neighborhoods here in the Tower District and in the Fresno High area. But those are the kinds of things that I've learned to not only work hard, but work with the state and figure out how we can really push our federal government to give us the resources that we need so we're tackling the issues that are impacting our community.
Wow. Yeah. I love all of that, but I'd be remiss if we just didn't take 10 seconds and give your mom and dad a shout out. You know, you know, seventh and ninth grade educated to, mm-hmm. you know, bring that vision, to set the example for that we came five children. Congratulations, mom and dad.
I will tell you, they are my motivation and my inspiration every single day. And in fact, when we talk about, you know, why am I running for Congress?
Yes.
Well, I'm running for Congress to be able to represent people like my family. My parents worked their tail off their entire, you know, the entire time they've been able to work. My father, unfortunately, this January had to retire. Not because he wanted to, but he was forced to retire because my mother, and I've shared this story publicly many times, my mother about 5 years ago, 4 to 5 years ago, got diagnosed with Alzheimer's. Uh-huh. And so fast forward, 5 years later, my mother needs 24/7 care. So my father has become her caretaker. Yeah. And what I saw as a result of that, my dad had, you know, he essentially had a low wage paying job the entire time he's worked. Because again, he doesn't have an education and he didn't pay into a big pension or he doesn't have a reliable pension. He doesn't have, you know, he's now relying on what many of our seniors here in our community, Medicare for the health needs that they both have. But what we have found is because they are low income working people, they don't have all the luxuries that some of us enjoy. And there's tons of people like my parents. You know, what I've seen in my family, my dad had to travel earlier this year to Mexico to get a special procedure done because his insurance wouldn't have covered and had the portion that it would have covered would have been small and he would have to pay a lot out of pocket. So we traveled to Mexico to get care. My mother, you know, also for some of her prescription costs, we've had to travel to Mexico because the prescription costs are much lower in Mexico and the care is also much lower in Mexico. So, you know, those are the things that for me motivate me and remind me there's a lot of work to do in Congress so that people like my family have the ability to still, you know, live a decent life after they've worked so hard in this country.
Absolutely, for sure. The other thing I want to make sure we touch on is you are running for Congress in a special part of Fresno to myself. Obviously, I've planted roots there with our office called The Hub right there on Van Ness. So introduce the people to what is the district, which one it is, and all of that. We'll talk a little more about that.
Perfect. So the district encompasses three counties. It is the southern portion of the city of Fresno. So it encompasses pretty much all of District 1, which is the area that I represent. So anything south of Shaw Ashland area, in the southern part of the city. Then it includes the entire county of Madera and the entire county of Merced. So there's tons of communities in this district. And in fact, we were just in Los Banos yesterday doing a meet and greet with folks out in the community.
Yeah, and I invest in all those communities. So, and you know, we met personally, I guess it was a couple of weeks ago, and I just loved your story and your passion. And I know you are going to help people. That's why I wanted to have you on this. And again, our stories are similar, right? I was the first college educated individual. My parents are high school graduates. They had, you know, they were just daily, you know, they just didn't have high paying jobs. And now it's about reaching down and picking people up. I love that you're going and helping the folks who put in the time and having care and all of that. And now you're covering the tower, which is just home for me and my investments. I couldn't imagine a better partnership. Anything else you want to kind of talk about that's a passion project for you and you really want to tackle when you get into Congress? Because there's so many things you could do, but what are the first couple of things you think?
Well, so, you know, my platform is very basic. It's in line with kind of my life story is I want to make sure every single person has access to healthcare. Yep. I think that's bottom line. People shouldn't have to go bankrupt because they're sick or because they are taking care of a loved one. You know, we're in a first world country. We're on the greatest country on this earth. And we should make sure that everyone has that access to healthcare. Number two for me is jobs and building the middle class and supporting the middle class. I think for far too long, our middle class has been squeezed, right? Yes, if you're low income, you get the assistance, but if you're in the middle class or right at the, you know, at the cusp, you don't get some of the resources that will propel you to continue to succeed in our country. And so that's why for me, creating better jobs and making sure that education is affordable, because again, I've seen the impact of college debt and the hindrance it does. Fortunately, I've been able to become a homeowner, but I know other people haven't had the ability because they're straddled with debt. So we got to get a handle on that, because I know that that's going to have a positive impact in our community. We want more people to be homeowners. As you know, someone that has done very well for yourself in this industry, you know the importance of homeownership, because it does that kind of help build wealth in our community. And so we should want to strive to do that. And guess what? The federal government does play a role in that. Every year, it does roll out resources for infrastructure, which infrastructure, we know if we have infrastructure, it will attract investment into our community, more housing, more development. We also have the ability to invest in housing dollars. And in the last, at least in the time that I've been on the council, like the city of Fresno gets $1 million in housing dollars. You know, because of the cost of housing, that with $1 million, you can't really build too many units. You know, it is very, very costly. So we need to make sure that the government, the federal government, is looking at those types of resources and investing in particular in communities like Fresno. And not just to build affordable housing, but to provide people the opportunity to become first-time home buyers. I saw that the impact that it made in my family's life. You know, after my parents were able to buy their first home, they had a little bit of equity that when they became, you know, they struggled with something and they need a little bit of money, they were able to pull from that. And so that's what helped build that American dream. And we need to make that American dream a reality for more people in our community.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. The other thing that I really loved about your story is, if I'm correct, you're running up against somebody that I would call a career politician, which makes me feel all icky inside. I think anybody that spends, you know, 30, 40 years as a career politician has learned to play the system for their own betterment, and are no longer caring, right? That's a long time, right? 40 years brings you all the way back to the 70s, for goodness sakes, right? Yeah. The world is different. Technology is different. And I want to see you win and succeed, frankly, for fresh blood and new ideas. You know, do you want to say anything on that, or you just want to leave that alone?
No. Absolutely. I think that that's a big distinction is, I think when you've been there way too that long in office, people become complacent, you know? And so for me, I'm at a point where I see it in the classroom. I'm also, I forgot to mention earlier, but I'm also an adjunct faculty at Fresno City College. So I see it in the classroom. I'm seeing it in the district that I represent here in the city of Fresno and the work that I've done, that we cannot afford status quo. And you know, more of the same doesn't lead to anything better. So for me, it is, we need change, we need new energy, we need new ideas. And that's what I want to bring to this seat. That's what I want to bring to the valley. My whole thing is, we need to have a greater vision, not only for the city of Fresno, but for the entire region. And there's been a lot of talk, and I know that Fresno, the California has led the way on kind of the issue of climate change. I know that can be a little bit controversial, but I see that as an opportunity for the Central Valley to have a vision
for sure
to build better jobs in our community. It's like, why can't the Central Valley be the Silicon Valley of renewable energy? We need to think big. We need to think 10, 20, 30 years from now into the future, and so that we're setting families up for that and for additional success here in our community. We can't continue to just rely on low-wage jobs. We know that doesn't help any community. You know, we'll continue to see the same poverty, the same disinvestment, you know, the crime, because all of that is correlated. Sure. And so I want to bring that change. I want to bring that fresh perspective. And I have that fight, and I have a track record of doing the work here locally. And that's what I want to do for the people of this valley.
Yeah, you absolutely have the fight, the passion, the heart as well to do it. And again, I do think I want you to win, because I want to see what the next 10 to 20 year vision is, because Fresno, the Central Valley, can and should be bigger than it is today. And I look forward to seeing you win this and all of that. I know to win it, you need donations, you need support. So how can people follow you, donate, you know, how can they do all of that? And then I want to announce something after that, but go ahead.
Perfect. So what we are on every social media platform. So follow us on Twitter, follow us on Instagram, and follow us on Facebook. We do also have a website. It is SoriaForCongress.com. And so follow us. There is a donate link there. You can put it, you know, I don't know if you're allowed to put it on your video or whatnot, but you can put a link on there and people can just follow us. We are relying on all individual contributions because this is the way that we're going to demonstrate that we're giving back the power to the people, to the voters, to the residents. That's what this campaign is about. And so it is tough because I'm going up against, you know, a career politician, but I think that it is possible. We were able to demonstrate in the first 3 months that we raised over $150,000 in individual contributions from business owners, from just regular everyday people that believe that we need change in our valley.
Yeah, we absolutely need change. I want you to win. I want to announce something on this channel and challenge all of my listeners to this. I want to donate $1,000, but I want it to be, I'm going to match what my listeners do up to $1,000. So hopefully we can all donate at least $2,000. So you're going to go to the donate link and I am going to trust you. Leave a comment below with how much you donated. And in the next 5 days, I'm hoping you guys donate up to $1,000. So I will match it and we will all donate a total of $2,000 to her campaign. So again, go donate. Leave a comment with your amount. I'm going to add them all up in 5 days and I will match that up to $1,000. So thank you very much.
Oh, for you're so awesome.
No, you're so awesome.
That means a lot to me.
No, you're awesome. You're the one taking on the fight. I admitted right at the beginning, I don't have the heart or the courage to take on Washington. I'm going to back people that I believe in. You're one of them. So folks, again, donate. I will put the link in the description. Leave a comment with how much you did in the next 5 days. I'm really hoping we see over $1,000 in donations. So let's see what this channel can do. Any closing thoughts?
Awesome. Well, first I want to thank you, Michael, for taking the time to invite me to be part of your little channel. I love it. I love what you're doing in the tower. And, you know, I was very impressed coming to visit the hub. I'm excited. I told you it's like the Bitwise of, you know, real estate and investment in the community. And I love the fact that you guys love these old neighborhoods. I'm actually right here at home in the tower. I live on Luzerne Lane. It's not a secret. Everyone knows. And so it's just exciting to see the love and the energy that you guys are putting to invest in this part of town because it definitely needs it. So thank you so much for the work that you guys are doing, your team. I know the other folks that you're partnering with and that you're working with also love this community. So thank you so much.
You got it. Excellent. Go get them.
Awesome. We'll be in touch.
Thanks.